And so the first Dragonborn beats the last Dragonborn at the summit of Apocrypha. No doubt, just as Hermaeus Mora intended. He is a fickle master, you know. But now I will be free of him. My time in Apocrypha is over. You are here in your full power, thus subject to my full power. You will die, and with the power of your soul, I will return to Solstheim and be master of my own fate once again.
Think to escape me, Mirak. You can hide nothing from me here. No matter, I have found a new dragonborn to serve me.
May he be rewarded for his service, as I am.
Mira harbored fantasies of rebellion against me. Learn from his example. Serve me faithfully, and you will continue to be richly rewarded.
I can feel it. The tree stone is free again. The oneness of the land is restored. Does that mean... is it over? Is Mirak defeated? Thank you. Whatever your other reasons for acting, you have done the Skull a great service. We will not forget what you have done. One more thing, Skull friend, if you will. I know it is not my place, but may I offer a word of advice, of warning? As shaman of the Skull, I am charged with the spiritual well-being of my people. While you are not of the Skull, you are Skull friend. And so I give you this warning. Hermamora forced you to serve him in order to defeat Mirak. Do not let him lure you further down that path. The Allmaker made you Dragonborn for a higher purpose. Do not forget that. Walk with the Allmaker, Skull friend.
My mother was Skull, but she left the village, and I was born in Skyrim.
It is good to see you again, my friend. Did you find the elves at their ship? I know you faced great danger to bring this map to me. There are no words to tell how glad my heart is. Thank you, brave one. I name you Friend of the Skull, and I will trust you with the knowledge of forging the Stalrim. If you bring Stalrim here to my forge, and use my tools to make what you will from it. Until our next meeting, Skull friend. May your hunts always bring you game, and your crops grow tall and beautiful.
I heard from Dior how you went in search of Baldur. That was very brave. And in fact, that's just the kind of courage I'm looking for. I heard from Dior how you went in search of Baldur. That was very brave. And in fact, that's just the kind of courage I'm looking for. Modest as well as brave. Most admirable. I can see why the Skull think highly of you. Yes, I think you're just the adventurous sort I need. I have a job offer for you. As a scholar of history, I've always found Solstheim to be most intriguing. I've made many forays into the ancient ruins that cover the island. I've come to know those ruins so well, I could draw you a map from memory. That's why I noticed the new passage the moment I laid eyes on it. An old tomb, I think. It must have been opened by an earthquake that accompanied one of the Red Mountain's eruptions. I'd love to have a closer look. Those old ruins can be dangerous, and I'm no adventurer. I'll pay you to watch my back down there. I'll be heading back there soon. If you're interested, meet me at the ruins, and we'll see what we can find. Now I'm off to pack for the expedition.
My son and I gather items to trade with travelers who visit the village.
We're nearly out of coal again.
It's been many winters since. His name is Nicholas. He's a good lad, strong and loyal. I only wish he wasn't so eager to leave the village. I've tried to tell him that the world beyond our lands is dangerous and cruel, but he won't listen.
Very well.
Perhaps someday I will have to. But for now, I need Nicholas here. You see, his father, my husband, was recently lost to us. Nicholas is all that I have left in this world. I know it is selfish of me to say so, but I cannot lose him. Not while I still grieve. Also, I know his heart. Nicholas is reckless and foolish, like most young men. He cannot understand what awaits him in the wide world. You would do that? I know he would listen to you. You've been out there in the wide world. You know its perils. Yes, perhaps you can convince him. I would be grateful if you would do this thing, outsider. Many hunters pass through our village, and sometimes the Dark Elves of Ravenrock visit us. They bring us things from their homeland that we can't find on the island, such as spices, fine cloth, and ores that we cannot mine here. It's true we Skull prefer a simpler life than some, but we do still enjoy a luxury from time to time. I hope that you can make my son see wisdom.
Papa, when can I go on my first hunt?
I've told you before, little girl, you're not old enough yet.
I just want to see you. I promise not to leave you. And I'm not afraid of the beasts.
I have given my answer. You are brave and have the heart of a great sheep. All things have a time and a place.
Yes, Papa.
That the son of the smith take his father's place, but you have no son. Who will become smith of the skull after you?
We'll make our wedding young Nicholas. I'd be happy to teach him.
I fear what would have happened if you hadn't freed us.
He's like an eagle, always seeking to fly somewhere new. I do not think he has the patience.
I welcome you, friend of the skull.
If Nicholas leaves me now, I will be truly alone. I hope that you can make my son see wisdom.
It's good to see you again, Skull friend. By saving Baldur, you helped to preserve our sacred traditions.
The blood of wolves runs through your veins, Skull friend.
Talk all of right, Great City is much bigger than our village. But why would anyone need so many buildings?
I've seen outsiders in our village before, but none were like you. That's right. I want to go out into the world and earn great glory. I want to hunt the deadliest creatures and claim vast riches. I'm wary of living in this village. I want to do something with my life other than farm, fish, and hunt deer. I know it must be hard for an adventurer such as you to understand this, but we Skull live very boring lives. There is truth in your words. She has not been herself since my father's death. I can see that in my eagerness for adventure, I have forgotten my duties as a son and as a Skull. You have helped me to see wisdom, and I thank you for that, Skull friend.
It's been many winters since my husband returned to the Allmaker, but my heart still aches from the loss. May the Allmaker bless you with many sons and daughters, Outsider. Once again, you have shown that you are a true friend of the Skull. I wish that I could give you a reward that is equal to the joy in my heart, but I don't have much to offer one who has so much already. Perhaps these will prove useful to you. These herbs are unique to the island, and their light cannot be found elsewhere. Until next time.
Just...
with me? What's the matter with you?
Sorry, I've just had a lot of hawk-faced cowards coming by to mock my efforts.
It probably can't hurt to tell you. You look mostly honest. The name's Rollis. Rollis Sedaris, out of Morhold. I've got a financier waiting for me back on the mainland. Sent me here in the interests of obtaining some rare antiquities, the relics of Azador. But this whole thing became a disaster right quick, let me tell you.
You come out of the Northern Ashlands, you don't expect things to go easy, you know. But this was something outside my particular expertise. When I first got to Kolbjorn, you couldn't even see it. Buried in the ash, like most other things on this blasted island. Dug out a pile of the stuff taller than me just to find the barrow. Who knows how much to reach the door? Excavating isn't exactly my specialty. Even if it was, the ash storms fill it in faster than you can dig. You think I've got that kind of money? No. I only get paid on delivery. Can't afford to go out of pocket for 1,000 septims on this. Takes money to make money, all that rot. There's a lot of it at the other end. But I can't get there without a little kick to start it off.
You ever hear of Azador? He was the first great Nord enchanter, maybe even the first human to master elven methods. His best work was buried with him, though. A set that my patron calls the relics are supposed to be down in his tomb.
Now, they're old, and they're powerful. A combination like that makes them pretty valuable to certain people, and I happen to know certain people. What? Are you serious? Well, I think I could make that work. We can sort out the details part of arrangement later.
But for now, I'll manage the dig if you can manage the coin. Do you have the gold? It's all here. Well then, looks like I have a good bit of work to start on.
I'll head back to Raven Rock and round up some diggers. Once we've got something worth looking at, I'll send word to you. Pleasure doing business with you, partner.
I'll see you soon.
Remarkable, isn't it? This tomb has been hidden for, well, who knows how long? Many centuries, I would think. There are some sealed doors up ahead. Perhaps you can figure out how to get them open. Lead the way. I've had a look around, and the only interesting thing I've found is this inscription here, and a switch below it. Now, I'm not sure if you can read the dragon language, but this seems to be a riddle of some sort. A sacrifice will bring you closer to that which you seek. I wonder what it means. Mind your step. There seem to be some corpses strewn about on the floor here. I wonder if this fire pit has anything to do with the riddle. You go ahead and see what you can figure out. I'll look around and see if I can find anything of use. This fire seems significant. Walking in these chambers is like walking in the past. in either direction. Since you seem to know what you're doing, why don't you lead the way? Three pillars. Other than that plaque, there doesn't seem to be anything else worthy of note. Let's see what the inscription says. All men must die, often by their own means. Sounds rather grim, if you ask me. The inscription must be a reference to these pillars. Three pillars surrounding a central one. Perhaps they're connected somehow. They also have glowing stones of some kind at the top. They look vaguely similar to drawings I've seen of objects called impact stones. Well, see what you can figure out. I'm going to inspect these pillars further to see if I've missed something. Simply fascinating. Ah, that's the trick. There you go. Now let's see what mysteries await us in the next room. expect there's another riddle in here, along with a puzzle. Continue along the path. Don't tread where you've been. Interesting. Well, I'm pretty sure about two things. One, the riddle is most likely referring to these flat square stones. And two, I'm not going anywhere near them. This is most exciting, wouldn't you agree? More to go. Now let's just hope something good happens when you hit the last one. I'll have to come back to this. And splendid! The gates have opened. This is most exciting. Don't you agree? Ah, so that's where that goes. Now, let's see if we can find the other half of that claw. Here's another riddle. Stay your course, to idle is to die. Well, at least it's straightforward. There appears to be a switch of some kind here. I'll just stand over here while you flip that switch. By the Nine, I've never seen anything like this. They appear to be platforms made entirely of magical force.